Well, now here we'll see how to achieve this result, and this result is achieved using custom scroll view. And custom scroll view has special effect like this one, or like certain part you scroll, or expandable header section like that. Okay, well, to do that we'll come over here, and within our food folder we'll create a new file, and we'll call it recommended food detail. Okay, and over here we'll create a stateless class, and we'll call it recommended food detail. Okay, all right, now we need to import the necessary libraries. Okay, well, now here we'll return scaffold. And within scaffold we'll have body, and within body we'll return custom scroll view. Okay, well, now custom scroll view, it takes slivers, so we'll go ahead and declare slivers. Okay, now what is slivers? Well, slivers are a special widget that has special effects. Okay, you can understand like this, like this is a sliver over here because it has a special effect. As you can see, it disappears slowly, and it has a color, whatever color you want to define. And actually this is also sliver here, this body section, okay, because it can scroll through, but of course we can do much more. All right, yeah, so here we have two sliver component, one is this one and another is this one. So slivers property over here, it takes a list of slivers. Okay, so first sliver we are going to use, that's called sliver app bar. Okay, so sliver app bar. Okay, now sliver app bar has a property called flexible space, so that's one we're going to use. So flexible space bar. Now why we are going to use this, because we want to have this background image. Okay, now we want to have this background image and slowly disappear it and show a certain color. That's what we want. Okay, so that's why we are going to use flexible spacebar. Now it has a property called background. Okay, background takes actually image, so here we do image.asset. Now here we need to mention the image path, so here we do our images all are in assets folder, inside that image folder, and inside it food 0.png. So this is the image we are going to use, so you can use whatever image you want, and make sure that you type in the image path correctly. So here we'd use our additional properties. One of the property is width. Now here we want the image to take the complete width, so max finite. And after that, what we'll do, we'll come to our main file over here. Instead of popular, we'll write here recommended. All right, yeah, and make sure that you import it. I think I might have a typo over here. Let's see, recommend, well, I think it should be ed, I'm sorry. So I'll just copy this one, put it right there, and over here I'll put the same. Okay, all right, so anyway, so I'll come over here, and now I'll save it, and I'll run it on, say, iPhone 12 over here. So let's see, where is my iPhone 12? So this is my iPhone 12 over here, and definitely this is not what we expected. Okay, but at least we can see things. So we want it to take the complete space, okay, the width. All right, but it's not, because it's missing a property called box fit. So box fit dot cover, now it'll force it to be as a container. All right, now, well, we saw early that we want to achieve this result, this height. Okay, now this is called expandable height, which could be expanded. Okay, yeah, so that's what we want to achieve. So here there is a property called expanded height, and for now I'll put it 300, and we'll come over here. We already see that it's expanded. Okay, So when it expands up to 350. So that's why it's called expanded height. Okay, and you can already see that you can squeeze it or scroll it. But if we are going to achieve this result, now we need to have some more slivers within this slivers list, okay? And then they'll all scroll together, okay? And this special effect. So we want to use another sliver, but that sliver will put inside the body section of the screen, inside the body of custom scroll view. And that kind of sliver, one of them is sliver to box adapter. So as you can see, this sliver, it adapts inside a box, okay? Or inside custom scroll view. Okay, so now here it takes a child, and now in our case, the child could take any kind of text over here. And now for this text itself, what I'll do, I'll come over here and copy this long text, okay? I'll copy it from here, and let's see, I'll put it there, okay? I'm sorry, I think I need to put inside this thing, and I'll put it a few times. So it is really a long text, as you can see from here. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll go ahead and copy it, and I'll check it on my phone. Okay, now it's already there. As you can see, that's a scrollable. Okay, now with this, we are already getting better. A few other things that we can take care. Now we want it to stack over here, okay? So there is a property which is called pinned. Now over here, I'll use it as a true, okay? All right, now it can expand up to 300, and when it gets pinned, we have this certain height, okay? All right. And at the same time, we can use this another property which is called background color. And for background color, I'll use a custom color. You can use any color you want. So app colors dot yellow color, okay? Now it's yellow because I want to stick to my design, okay? All right, okay. Now there's another thing that I want to achieve. Achieve like this one over here, as you can see, okay? So I want to achieve this kind of bar over here. Regardless, you want this with this background, I mean this border or not, but I want to achieve this result, okay? Now to do that, we have to use another property, which is called preferred size, okay? Inside bottom property. So bottom takes preferred size widget. So that's what we're going to use, okay? Now it has a property, let's see another preferred size, inside preferred size. So here actually pretty much you mention the size that you want. So you'd use size dot from height, and we'll use 20 over here. And I think it takes another child over here. And as a child for now, I'll just pass a random text over here, and I'll call it sliver app bar, okay? Now I'll come to my phone over here, which is this one, okay? Now I'll save it and see the result. Okay, so it took some space over here, okay? Well, I mean, it didn't really take space, it just showed up over here, okay? Now, of course, you can do zero. All right, now it's still there, okay? Well, now over here, we can do much more than this, because this is just text over here, right? But we want it to have a background color. So for that one, actually, what I'll do, I'll use a container, okay? Now, container, I'll use, say, color. Sorry. We do colors.white. Okay. All right. And it looks like it's gone, okay? Yeah. Now, of course, because we don't have anything as a child over here, so we'll pass a text over here, and now I'll say sliver app bar. Just now we didn't have any content, so it was gone. Now it showed up once again. Now here, let's see. We can use other property, which is called width. So we'll use double dot max finite. So it'll take the complete space over here, and it's already looking better. And as well as over here, inside the container, we can use another property which is called padding. And here we do edge insets only. Now here I'll do top 5 and say bottom 10. Okay, so it's looking already better. Okay, and over here we want to center this, so I'll wrap it around center widget, so it would be centered. So it's already centered. Okay, all right, and it's already looking great. Now of course I don't want to use this text over here. I want to use our custom text, which is big text. Okay, and here I'll have a different name over here. I'll say Chinese side, and that's it. Okay, yeah. Now for this one, I can use a different font, different size, okay, because I think it's too small. You can use whatever size you want. Okay, now here we would do dimensions font 26, because we know that in our dimensions file we have all the font size saved. Okay, all right, so it's already looking bigger. Okay, right. Now for the container itself, we can also apply a bit of margin. So here we do margin. Okay, now for margin we do edge insets only. Now here we'll have left, and for left we'll have dimensions dot width 20, and right dimensions dot with 20. Okay, all right. Oops, I'm sorry, this shouldn't be applied here. Made a mistake. I'll cut that and I'll save it. Actually, I wanted to apply it over here. Now to be able to apply it over here, we need to wrap things around a container. Okay, well, we'll do that. Let's see. Yes, anyway, so now I'll come over here. So there is a bit of problem though. Now, as you see, it's not as big as before. So here, let's see, try 20. So it came down a little bit, okay? And this is what we want to actually achieve, okay? So that's the preferred size. So you can use extra size if you think you are not satisfied, okay? So if you take it out, so it goes up 20 pixels. If you put it back, it comes down a lot of pixels, I guess. Anyway, so now the next thing we want to achieve is this result, these two icons. Okay, so that's what we want to achieve over here. Now for that one, we can use another property within Sliver app, which is called a title, and title takes actually widget, any kind of widget. So within it we'll use our children. Now here I could go ahead and simply put any icons. So icons dot icons, say whatever the icon you want, and that would definitely show up. Let's go ahead and check it. So it's iPhone 12, and as you can see, it's already there. Okay, yes. Now of course this is not the icon we want. We already have our custom icon, so that's what that one we'll use. Okay, app icon, let's see this one. Okay, now here all we need to do, pass the icon name. So icons dot well, we do have this clear. Okay, this is what we'll use, and it'll show up over here, and it's a beautiful icon. And then we'll use another icon, so app icon here, icons dot shopping. Let's see what shows up. So we'll use this one. Okay, all right. Okay, so these two icons are together, so we'll use a property of row which is called main axis alignment. So we do main axis alignment dot space between, so we see that they go far to this end. All right, yeah, Okay, now there's this problem. You see, it kind of cut off. Okay, now to get rid of this problem, we have to use another property, which is called toolbar height. Now we'll set it to 60. Okay, and it's got a little better. Okay, all right. Or we could use more of them actually. So use 80. Okay, yeah. So now it's better, but in my case, I'll just go ahead and stick with 70 and we'll see how it looks. Okay, all right. So it's already looking better. Okay, yeah, so we are almost very close to the result we wanted to achieve, which is this one. And we also have to achieve this result, right? Okay. Now, this result is actually done within this container itself. Okay, now here you see this is a border, right? So all we could do, we could come over here and here we do decoration and box decoration. And here we do border radius and border radius dot only. Now here we do top left and we do radius dot circular, and you can just go ahead with 20, or the one we have saved in our file, we'll use that one, radius 20. Okay, now what I will do, I'll go ahead and copy that, and instead of top left, we'll use top right. Okay, all right, and let's see. And of course, this is the color, so as we are using decoration, color has to be inside decoration. Now we'll go ahead and save it and let's see how it looks like. Yes, it's already looking better. Okay, yeah. Okay, now I think instead of top five, well, yeah, it does look okay. All right. Okay, so the next thing we want to achieve is this thing over here, and we want to make it scrollable, okay? All right. Well, to make it scrollable, definitely scrollable like, I mean, like this kind of scrollable, okay? Or collapsible, I would say. So this is what we want to achieve, okay? Well, to do that, over here, we'll have this text, we have this child, right? So over here we'll use a column, and within column we'll use children, and within children we'll use a container. Okay, container. And within container I'll have child, okay? Now within child I'll use this one, expandable text widget, and it takes a text property. Now here I'll put the text that we had early. So I'll just copy it a few more times from one more time over here, and I'll put it here a few more times. It'll be a long text, okay? All right. Now if I save this, I will see this result over here, okay? That I can already scroll and collapse this one, okay? Like if I come over here. All right, okay. Now, another thing, why I use container, because we want to apply margin to it or padding, right? So the container outside, I can use a margin. So I would do margin over here, okay? And edge, let me go ahead and do it right after it. So margin. Now here we do edge insets dot only. Now here, always left. So dimensions dot width 20, right, dimensions dot width 20. Okay, all right. Now let's save it, and it's already looking better. But now we have this background color issue, so we want to use scaffold background color over here, and we'll do colors dot white. And it looks much better now. Okay, all right. So this is the result we wanted to achieve, and here we are. Okay, all right. Well, next we'll see how to achieve this result over here. This one.